Namaskar, good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with News Tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the headlines. Opposition is misleading people on the Citizenship Amendment Act at a rally in Hubli, Karnataka. Home Minister Amit Shah asserts the act was brought in to protect human rights. Hundreds of Pakistani refugees living in Delhi and Haryana thank government, addressing them at the BJP headquarters. BJP's National Executive President JP Nadda accuses opposition of doing vote bank politics, emphasizes that law doesn't take citizenship. Remover of Article 370 in Jammu and Kashmir, a historic step and a bold attack on terrorism. Union Minister Jitendra Singh gives an account of development policies of the central government in Jammu, says government employees getting better facilities now. States can't refuse to implement Citizenship Amendment Act. Congress leader Kapil Sibal says doing so will be unconstitutional. And Southern Command Chief Lieutenant General S.K. Saini to take charge as a new Vice Chief of Indian Army on 25th January. First senior military appointment order issued through Department of Military Affairs, headed by Chief of Defence Staff, General Bipin Rawat. Union Home Minister Amit Shah on Saturday addressed a rally in Karnataka's Hubli in support of the Citizenship Amendment Act, emphasizing that there was no clause in the new act that takes away the citizenship of Muslims. Shah targeted the Congress party for trying to create confusion over the act.
Aaj Narendra Modi ji inke manav adhikar ki raksha karne ke liye unko nagrikta dene ka kanoon lekar aaye hain. Jara bataiye to aapko dikkat kya hai? Main batata hu unko kya dikkat hai. उनको अपनी वोट बैंक की राजनीति करनी है, वोट बैंक की राजनीति करनी है. राहुल बाबा, मैं आपको इस मंच पर से चैलेंज देने आया हूं कि पूरा नागरिकता कानून को पढ़िए. अगर इसकी कोई भी क्लॉज के अंदर किसी की नागरिकता लेने की बात आपको दिखाई पड़ती है तो स्थान और समय तय करिए. हमारा प्रहलाद जोशी आपके साथ चर्चा करने के लिए तैयार है. राहुल बाबा, आपके परनाना जो गलती कर गए थे जवाहरलाल जी, वो गलती को नरेंद्र मोदी ने सुधारने का काम किया है, सुधारने का काम. और आज धारा 370 हट गई है और कश्मीर के अंदर अपना तिरंगा आसमान को छूता हुआ वहां पर फहरा रहा है.
शाह आल्सो अटेंडेड एन इवेंट ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय वेदांता भारती in Bangalore, where he called Prime Minister Narendra Modi the flag bearer of Indian culture and tradition across the globe.
अनेक सालों तक आजादी के बाद सरकारें चली धर्म निरपेक्षता की गलत व्याख्या के कारण एक लघुता ग्रंथि से प्रेरित सरकारों ने अपना जो श्रेष्ठ है, अपना जो सर्वश्रेष्ठ है, उसका गौरव करना छोड़ दिया था. बहुत समय के बाद देश ने एक ऐसा प्रधानमंत्री देखा जो शपथ लेने के पहले वाराणसी में गंगा आरती करने के लिए जाता है और गौरव के साथ भभूति लगाकर गंगा आरती कर पूरी दुनिया को संदेश देता है कि हमारे पास आपको देने के लिए बहुत कुछ है. बहुत समय के बाद हमने एक ऐसा प्रधानमंत्री देखा जो नेपाल के पशुपतिनाथ मंदिर के अंदर जाकर भारत सरकार की ओर से रक्त चंदन की भेंट भी चढ़ाता है और भगवान पशुपतिनाथ का अभिषेक भी करता है. मोदी जी ने हमारे देश की संस्कृति को हमारे देश के संस्कार को और हमारे देश की परंपरा को पूरी दुनिया में पहुंचाने का प्रयास किया है.
And BJP working president JP Nadda accused the opposition of misleading people on the new law. Addressing a group of minority refugees from Pakistan at the party headquarters in New Delhi, Nadda said the opposition is indulging in vote bank politics over the issue. He said the law is for those who have come to India on or before December 31st, 2014. Adding that Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru and Manmohan Singh supported helping religious minorities in neighboring countries who face persecution there.
जब मोदी जी ने ये करके दिखा दिया 2014 में 31 दिसंबर के पहले आए हुए सब लोगों को भारत की नागरिकता देने को तय कर दिया जिसके आधार पर आपको नागरिकता मिल रही है तो इन्होंने राजनीतिक रोटियों को सेकने के लिए वोट बैंक की राजनीति को ध्यान में रखते हुए देश से ऊपर वोट को रखा और लोगों को गुमराह करने का काम शुरू कर दिया. क्या गुमराह किया? करोड़ों लोग आ जाएंगे, देश कैसे चलेगा? अरे आएंगे नहीं, ये कानून उसके लिए है जो है यहां पर आए हुए हैं. फिर क्या भड़का रहे हैं? भड़का ये रहे हैं कि इससे तुम्हारी नागरिकता चली जाएगी. ये कानून ऐसा है जो नागरिकता लेता नहीं है, नागरिकता देता है, सिर्फ देता है. इसको भी समझना चाहिए. मोदी जी ने जो काम किया है वो मानवता का काम है, वो देश के हित का काम है. इसलिए उसमें हमें सफलता मिलेगी मिलेगी और उस सफलता में लोगों को मानवता के अधिकार पर उनको उनको सिटीजनशिप राइट मिलेगा, इस बात को हम जानते हैं.
Meanwhile, in response to Kerala government moving the Supreme Court against the CAA, former Union Minister and senior Congress leader Kapil Sibal has said that any state denying the implementation of the Citizenship Amendment Act would be unconstitutional.
This is a national legislation, so we shouldn't be scoring political points. You must know that if the CAA is passed, no state can say, I will not implement it. That's not possible. That is unconstitutional. You can oppose it. You can pass a resolution in the assembly and ask the central government to say, please withdraw it. But constitutionally, to say that I will not implement it is going to be problematic.
On to some more developments. A group of union ministers began their visit to Jammu and Kashmir on Saturday. The ministers will visit 60 different locations on different days in both the divisions of Jammu and Kashmir till 24th of this month. There will be 51 visits to Jammu and 8 to Srinagar, with Home Ministry coordinating the visits. The objective of the visit is to spread information about the importance of centre's policies for the overall development of the Union Territory and its people, along with the steps taken by the government. Union Minister Jitendra Singh, who arrived in Jammu, said that the abrogation of Article 370 was a historic step and the government employees are getting better facilities and terrorism is being efficiently countered.
ऐसे ऐसे आतंकवादियों को पकड़ा जा रहा है जिनको राजनीतिक शरण भी थी शायद और कहीं और जगह से भी संरक्षण मिलता था. रातों रात सरकारी कर्मचारियों की तनख्वाहें कितनी बढ़ गई, हम कहते हैं कुछ नहीं हुआ 31 अक्टूबर के बाद. और मेरा ये अनुभव है, जो छोटे प्रदेश हैं, जो छोटे केंद्र शासित प्रदेश हैं, क्योंकि 8 राज्यों के साथ मेरा वास्ता रहा, चाहे पूर्वोत्तर के यहां, वहां अधिकतर जनसंख्या सरकारी साधनों पर निर्भर करती है अपनी जीविका के लिए, बिकॉज द मेजोरिटी ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन इज इन द गवर्नमेंट सर्विस. आपकी 2 गुना 1.5 गुना वेतन बढ़ गया, 40 से 45 करोड़ रातों रात रिलीज किया गया आपको सिक्स पे कमीशन देने को, जिसकी जेब में पैसा गया कम से कम जेब तो खनकती होगी कि नहीं खनकती. सीजीएचएस का कवर आपको मिल गया सरकारी मुलाजमों को. पहले सरकार अपनी मर्जी से आपको मेडिकल अलाउंस दे देती थी ठगने के लिए, अब परिवार का प्रत्येक सदस्य सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट हेल्थ सर्विस स्कीम के अंतर्गत आता है। आजीवन और अगर आपको बीमारी का मिल जाए राहत तो फिर कितनी बड़ी राहत है। इसी प्रकार एजुकेशन लोन फॉर चिल्ड्रन एंड नॉट ओनली एजुकेशन लोन बट ऑल्सो दी हॉस्टल लोन, ये सब अभी हुआ है।
Meanwhile, broadband internet and 2G mobile services have been restored in Jammu and Kashmir. The Union Territory's Principal Secretary Rohit Kansal informed this while addressing the media on Saturday. 2G mobile internet services have been restored on postpaid mobile phones for accessing only whitelisted sites in all the 10 districts of Jammu and 2 districts of Kashmir. The voice call and SMS services have been restored for all prepaid connections across the Union Territory. The mobile internet connectivity shall, however, remain suspended in the districts of Srinagar, Budgam, Gandharbal, Baramulla, Anantnag, Kulgam, Shopian and Pulwama.
Consistent with the above philosophy and after a careful review, the competent authority has ordered today that voice and SMS facility shall be restored on all local prepaid SIM cards across the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Further, in order to consider provision of mobile internet connectivity on such SIM cards, the telecom service providers shall initiate the process of verification of credentials for these subscribers as per available norms for postpaid subscribers.
Minister for Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises, Prakash Javrekar, on Saturday inaugurated Elekrama 2020 in Greater Noida. Speaking on the occasion, Javrekar said, under the Saubhagya scheme, the government is working towards providing electricity to households of the poor. Stressing on the need to work for the welfare of the society, Javrekar said that industries should work in a way to translate their cause towards societal cause in order to grow exponentially.
Every electrical equipment का भी मांग जबरदस्त बढ़ने वाली है क्योंकि पीपल वांट न्यू फैसिलिटीज, पीपल वांट ईज ऑफ लिविंग एंड फॉर दैट दे थिंक इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज एन एसेट एंड ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स आर नाउ अवेलेबल ऑन इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सो पीपल वांट इट एंड पीपल विल बी यूजिंग इट। और हमारे यहाँ बेस इतना लो है, एयर कंडीशनिंग हो, कूलिंग हो, वॉशिंग मशीन हो, बाकी सब हो, तो वो इतना लो बेस है कि वहां ग्रोथ ही ग्रोथ है। लॉबिंग इज अ पॉजिटिव वर्ड, इट्स नॉट अ नेगेटिव एंड अंडर हैंड टेबल डीलिंग टेक्निक। लॉबिंग का मतलब केवल एक टैक्स पॉलिसी ट्विक करना या कोई नए चार कंसेशन मांगना नहीं है। लॉबिंग का मतलब है हमारा कॉज, इंडस्ट्री का कॉज, ये समाज का कॉज बन जाए। आवर इंडस्ट्री कॉज मस्ट ट्रांसलेट एज ए सोसाइटल कॉज, देन योर लॉबिंग इज सक्सेसफुल।
द नेशनल इन्वेस्टिगेशन एजेंसी विल प्रोब अ केस इन विच अ सीनियर जम्मू एंड कश्मीर पुलिस ऑफिसर वॉज अरेस्टेड व्हाइल फेरिंग थ्री टेररिस्ट आउट ऑफ द वैली। देवेंद्र सिंह, पोस्टेड एज द डेप्यूटी सुपरिंटेंडेंट ऑफ पुलिस, वॉज अरेस्टेड लास्ट वीकेंड along with Naveed Babu, self-styled district commander of band Hizbul Mujahideen, a new recruit Atif, and an advocate Irfan Mir. The four were caught with arms and ammunition while they were travelling in a car near Qazi Gund on the National Highway in South Kashmir. After receiving orders from the Union Home Ministry, the NIA has re-registered this case and started the investigation. National Security Advisor Ajit Doval is on a day-long visit to Sri Lanka. He met Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapakse. Key issues including economic and strategic cooperation were discussed. India had proposed several key projects in Sri Lanka, including investment in Eastern Container Terminal in Colombo and Matala International Airport. Doval's visit follows a Sri Lankan foreign minister, his visit to India last week, when several issues of bilateral cooperation came up for the review. Doval's visit assumes significance in view of Sri Lankan Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapakse's expected visit to India early next week. Southern Army Commander Lieutenant General S.K. Saini will take over as the new Vice Chief of the Army Staff on 25th of January. This is also the first order of a senior military appointment issued through the Department of Military Affairs, headed by Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat. General Saini is an alumnus of a Sainik School in Punjab's Kapurthala, National Defence Academy in Pune and the Indian Military Academy in Dehradun. He was commissioned into the Jat Regiment in June 1981. He has also served on international deputations. And with that, we'll slip into a very quick break. More news and updates on the other side. Stay with us.
Watch The Big Picture with me, Frank Rausen Pereira, at 9:30 p.m.
President Tsai Ing-wen re-elected in Taiwan. What does it mean for Taiwan-China ties? Protests in Iran over downing of airliner. Australia bushfires causing a wildlife catastrophe. Catch this week's big international stories on World Panorama on Sunday at 8 a.m. and 9 p.m. only on Rajya Sabha TV.
Nepal has undergone many transformations.
So what is the social situation now?
At least minimum 33% women will be member of parliament.
What is the situation of Madhesis now?
They are in the government, they were in the government.
Do you feel somehow or other you are being trapped between two, you know, large nations, India and China?
We are not trapped. We are lucky that we are bordering with the two great countries.
Watch Indian Standard Time. Exclusive interview of Nilambar Acharya, Ambassador of Nepal. Only on Rajya Sabha Television.
बजट से यही है कि जो डायरेक्ट टैक्सेस में जो हमारे यहाँ रिफॉर्म्स की बात चल रही है उस पर हम यही चाहते हैं कि सरकार उसमें काफ़ी अच्छे से रिफॉर्म्स एक बार कर दे ताकि आने वाले बहुत सालों तक सब ठीक हो जाए जो इतने सालों से नहीं हो पाया था
जो मिडिल क्लास ट्रेडर्स है उनके लिए लोन बैंक जो है कम से कम रेट पर दे ये हम बहुत ध्यान लगाए बैठे इस बार
हम चाहते हैं कि बजट में व्यापारियों को प्राथमिकता दी जाए व्यापारियों के जो विषय हैं टैक्सेस से संबंधित विषय हैं व्यापारियों को फाइनेंस नहीं मिलता उसके संबंध में विषय है या और जैसे विषय हैं उस विषय पर सरकार पॉलिसी अच्छी बना के लाए व्यापारियों के लिए बजट में इतना ही चाहते हैं
Welcome back after the break. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu visited the Ramakrishna Mission at Port Blair in Andaman and Nicobar on Saturday. Paying tribute to Swami Vivekanand, he said that the teachings of Swami Vivekanand are relevant in the present day and age. Naidu also appreciated several initiatives taken by the mission to impart education and free coaching for students from weaker sections of society. The Vice President said the Ramakrishna Mission was rendering invaluable service to humanity across the globe. The mission's activities cover different areas of human need and social welfare, like education, health, rural development, women's welfare, spiritual guidance, and relief to victims of calamities. Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla has underscored the need to raise the standard of education, keeping in view of the global challenges. Addressing the 70th anniversary of the Hyderabad Sindh National Collegiate Board in Mumbai, Birla said that youth will have to be educated in a multifaceted manner to move ahead in today's competitive arena. He also called for more focus on skill development.
शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में भी हम किस तरीके से हमारे विद्यार्थियों को बदलती परिस्थितियों के अंदर प्रतिस्पर्धी बनाते हुए विश्व की चुनौतियों का सामना करने के लिए तैयार करें, यह हमारे लिए सबसे बड़ी चुनौती है। दुनिया के अंदर हमें प्रतिस्पर्धा से चुनौतियों का मुकाबला करना है तो हमें उच्च क्वालिटी की शिक्षा भी देना पड़ेगा, शिक्षा के साथ उसके संस्कार, विचार, बाहत्तिन रिसर्च और उसको बहुत आयामी तरीके से नौजवान को हमें शिक्षित और दीक्षित करने का काम करना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि दुनिया के अंदर अब केवल शिक्षा नहीं, शिक्षा के साथ साथ हम कौशल निर्माण के सेक्टर के अंदर भी हमें काम करने की आवश्यकता है।
Nripendra Mishra, former Principal Secretary to Prime Minister Narendra Modi, has been appointed the Chairman of the Executive Council of the Nehru Memorial Museum and Library, the highest decision-making body of the institution. The 8-member council has also been reconstituted with Prasar Bharati Chairman A. Suri Prakash as the new Vice Chairman. Indian Council for Cultural Relations Chairman Vinay Sahasrabuddhe and Rajya Sabha Member Swapan Das Gupta are among the other members. News now from the election-bound Delhi, where in a setback to the Aam Aadmi Party, two of its MLAs quit the party after they were denied election tickets. Aam Aadmi Party's Dwarka MLA in the outgoing assembly, Adarsh Shastri, joined the Congress at the party's Delhi unit office. Shastri quit the Aam Aadmi Party after it denied him ticket to seek a re-election from Dwarka constituency. He is expected to be fielded from the seat by his new party to contest the February 8th polls. Harinagar MLA Jagdeep Singh also resigned from the party after he was denied ticket in the upcoming election.
अब जब ये मैंने देखा कि किस तरह से द्वारका में जहाँ 5 साल से ईमानदारी से मैंने काम किया, वहाँ पे एक ऐसे आदमी को, ऐसे व्यक्ति को जिसके ऊपर क्रिमिनल केसेस हैं, गंभीर पॉस्को जैसे केस हैं, महिला के साथ अभद्रता के केस हैं, अबडक्शन का, किडनैपिंग का केस है, और ऐसे केसेस के बाद केवल पैसा देने की वजह से टिकट उसको दिया जा रहा है, तो मेरे को लगा पूरी तरह से अरविंद केजरीवाल और की ये सारी जो सोच है, बातें हैं, ये पूरी तरह से एक ढोंग है।
And Congress announced its first list of 54 candidates for Delhi Assembly elections for the 70-member assembly. In some prominent names, the party has fielded Harun Yusuf from Balli Maran and former Aam Aadmi Party leader Alka Lamba from Chandni Chowk. Lamba is sitting MLA from the same seat, but she contested the 2015 election on the Aam Aadmi Party ticket. The party is yet to name its candidate from AAP leader Arvind Kejriwal's constituency of New Delhi. Assam Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal expanded his ministry today with the induction of 2 ministers of the state with independent charge. Sanjay Kishan and Jogan Mohan were administered the oath of office and secrecy by Governor Jagdish Mukhi at a ceremony in the Darbar Hall in the Raj Bhavan in Guwahati. Both Kishan and Mohan are first-time BJP MLAs and represent Tinsukia and Mahamora assembly constituencies respectively. With this, the strength of the Sonowal ministry has increased to 18, including the chief minister, with 12 from the BJP and 3 each from the alliance partners Assam Gan Parishad and Bodo People's Front. The portfolios of the new ministers are yet to be announced. Some more developments. Delhi's Karkar Duma's court on Saturday found 2 men guilty of kidnapping and rape of a 5-year-old girl in 2013 in the national capital. A special POXO court found the 2 accused, Manoj Shah and Pradeep Kumar guilty of various offences. Announcing the verdict, the court said that the crime against the victim was committed in the most revolting manner and the collective conscience of the community was shaken. The court added that the victim child experienced exceptional depravity and extreme brutality. The court will announce the quantum of punishment on 30th of January. And now let us talk about the environment and climate change. Climate change is likely to have greater impact on rainforests than deforestation. A study to examine the way animals and plants make use of the forest and how they interact with each other was carried out in South America. Researchers say if a section of rainforest was cut down, some of the animals might vanish from that area. But the same species elsewhere could survive and other similar species could fill their space in the ecosystem. However, global warming is wiping out the entire species rather than just localized population. Earlier, it was believed that the multi-billion dollar logging industry posed the biggest threat to the ecosystem. But researchers now claim climate change has a bigger impact. Rainforests are a vital carbon store that not only slow down the pace of global warming, but are home to a significant number of unique species of plants and animals. Getting you some international developments, heavy rains and thunderstorms lashed parts of Australia's east coast, dousing some of its fires but bringing a new threat of flooding to some areas. There were downpours in the states of Victoria, New South Wales and Queensland that have all been badly hit by the bushfire crisis. Major roads were closed in Queensland and power cuts were reported in parts of NSW as a result of the weather. But fire officials said that the rain was helping to tackle some of its blazes. Fires have been raging in Australia since September, killing at least 28 people, destroying thousands of homes and scorching millions of acres of land. And that's all we have for you in this edition of News Tonight. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.
Watch the big picture.